Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will explain more about serialization in Java. So let's get started. Serialization converts objects into byte streams that can be stored, shared, and used by Java machines to reconstruct the objects. Object serialization is essential in Java software development, since it allows for data exchange between devices running on different hosts, enforcing platform independence. Serialization, however, offers an attack surface to hackers, as they can edit objects in byte streams or deploy malicious scripts in the runtime environment to create unexpected things. Java's serialization vulnerability is often exploited as an entry point for remote code execution and data tampering attacks. Using Java serialization, a user converts the state of objects into a binary format for storing in databases and physical file formats. Serialization helps Java-integrated development environments build a standard format for the object's primitive data types to be stored, transmitted, or reconstructed by other Java virtual machines. The mechanism also enables infrastructure independence, since the standardized format allows data exchange across programming languages and architectures. Java provides an automatic serialization mechanism that implements the Java EO serializable interface for each class object marked as serializable. The marker instructs the JVM to write a serializable object into the desired output byte stream using the object output stream write object method. The serializable interface implements a three-step process. 1. Writing metadata information of the object's class. 2. Recursively write out this class structure's description until it locates Java lang object. 3. Recursively writing out the data associated with the object stream, from the highest serializable fields to the lowest. Some use cases for serialization in Java include caching, replication, multi-tenant communication, persistence, and cross-machine synchronization. Caching. Object serialization saves the state of an object. In contrast, deserialization takes little time to recreate the original object, then building it from a Java class, saving time when accessing objects from cache memory. Replication. Byte streams can easily be shared across Java virtual machines that serialize them in little time. This allows for the provision of multiple object clones across different machines' environments for simple replication. Multi-tenant communication. Once the original object has been serialized, data structures can be transferred efficiently through a network of machines, exchanging information between different environments. Persistence. After applying serialization, Java can store the state of any object in a database or a file system that can be used later. Cross-machine synchronization. The serialization protocol generates byte streams that work across different architectures and operating systems, allowing for synchronization between different JVMs. The serialization process is crucial for Java applications since it provides a standard data structure and enables objects portability. Despite the benefits serialization in Java offers, such applications are susceptible to serialization vulnerabilities, where attackers can insert malicious objects into the runtime environment to compromise user or system data. These objects typically include payloads and private methods that run executable code on target JVMs. Once the attacker can control the data being serialized and deserialized, they can control program objects and in-memory variables, influencing the code flow within the application. The application is also susceptible to attacks if the object contains classes whose behavior can be altered during the deserialization process. In such cases, attackers can exploit existing data structures, change their contents, override existing variables, and exploit other vulnerabilities within the serialization mechanism. Serialization attacks are less likely to be performed automatically, as plenty of manual work is required to create a malicious object that the serialization mechanism considers valid. Once the hacker has successfully compiled the exploit on one JVM, they can execute malicious code remotely on all other machines hosting the same application. Once attackers gain control over the source code, they assume a complete host takeover of the vulnerable application. In such cases, detecting a successful exploit is highly complex. Potential factors that cause serialization attacks in Java include deserializing objects from untrusted sources and a large number of dependencies. Most attacks occur since development and operations teams fail to validate user-supplied data before deserializing an object. For applications that rely on the binary serialization format, developers assume that users cannot effectively read and manipulate object data and deem all deserialized objects trustworthy. With some effort, an attacker can craft exploits and inject malicious payloads into binary serialized objects, allowing them to abuse the application's logic. Typical Java web apps implement numerous libraries, each having its dependencies. Therefore, an application comprises many methods and classes that can be difficult to manage securely. This makes it difficult to predict and prevent a serialization attack, since a hacker can replicate any class and invoke one method to execute their malicious payload. Hackers can also connect several unexpected method invocations, so the final data parsed into the sink is entirely different from the initial input. Since developers cannot anticipate the flow of data in the application, it is almost impossible to address every security gap opened by the serialization vulnerability. There are multiple ways to exploit insecure serialization vulnerabilities in Java, such as modifying object attributes and data types, as well as extending application functionality. Some best practices to prevent serialization vulnerabilities include the following. Use non-native formats. Developers should use standard data formats such as XML and JSON, eliminating the chances of attackers repurposing custom deserialization logic for remote code execution. These non-native formats implement a secure data transfer pattern that creates a separate serialization protocol for objects and state transfer, making the serialization algorithm unavailable to external entities. Use RASP to prevent remote code execution. Runtime application self-protection tools are deployed into application servers to intercept all communications between the host and client machines and detect attacks in real time. These tools monitor data flows, systems, and user behavior to detect malicious activity. These tools also identify patterns in data structures and serializable objects to build context for regular user and application behavior. Any out-of-context data input is considered a potential threat. RASP tools can be configured to alert teams of attack attempts in diagnostic mode or mitigate the attacks in protection mode. Implement checks for data integrity, deserialize signed data. Complement blacklisting and pattern matching techniques with signature-based positive validation techniques to ensure user-provided data is trustworthy. Additionally, implement sufficient authorization authentication checks to verify the source of the input byte stream before deserializing it. Use custom deserialization methods. OWASP provides a cheat sheet with guidelines on building custom serialization and deserialization code to enumerate safe validation methods. These guidelines can ensure the application is free of untrusted data. Restrict classes to be serialized by subclassing Java EO Object Input Stream. The Java EO Object Input Stream class deserializes objects whose security can be hardened by subclassing them. This is achieved by overriding the objectmerresolve call, which restricts the classes that can be deserialized. Security teams can also deploy an agent that secures all usage of the java.eo Object Input Stream class to harden applications against unknown malicious data types. Use a vulnerability detection tool. Deploy a security testing tool that identifies static and dynamic application vulnerabilities through continuous scanning and testing. The Crashtest Security Suite helps scan OPIS and web applications to identify serialization vulnerabilities before attackers exploit them. Sign up for a free trial to begin a quick and efficient vulnerability scanning. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security Channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.